Hello, and welcome to my review of Mr. Miracle Issue 3, written by Tom King and drawn by Mitch Gerads. And I hope that life finds you well before we begin the review. Right now I'm at the end of Tet, which is New Year's for Vietnamese, as I live in Vietnam. And I'm enjoying the last day of my goatee, as I work at a job where you can't have facial hair. So during the 10 days of Tet, I grew out the goatee. And I'm very sad that I'll have to shave it tomorrow. Information about Mr. Miracle. It received a score from critics of 8.9 on Comic Book Roundup and a score of 9.0 from the users. Both those scores are amazing. The summary of the story, courtesy of Comic Book Roundup. The insanity of war is the insanity of Mr. Miracle. Darkseid and Orion's forces clash violently on the battlefield of New Genesis. Stained with blood and glory, the new gods fight on. As they move closer to victory, Scott and Barda begin to see that every step forward leads into a deadly trap. Where do you run when the path ahead is your enemy's triumph, and the path behind is your enemy's defeat? So, to begin with, I want to discuss the opening pages of issue number 3. They call back both issues 1 and issues 2. So give me 1 second and I'll bring up the image. Okay, I have it now. And if you remember the opening image of issue number 2, it was of Mr. Miracle on the battlefield of New Genesis. Are they fighting at New Genesis? Yeah, New Genesis. Correct. And Scott Free was killing, I guess, a bug? I'm not quite sure what that creature was. But we find ourselves back on New Genesis again with another bug. But this time, the circumstances are a little different. So, there we go. And here, it's Orion getting a bug to unbury the body of Granny Goodness. And as he's doing this, as they're unburying the body, we get a story about a boy during World War II who, I believe it was in, they say the country is one of the Scandinavian countries, who inadvertently tells the authorities that his family's hiding a Jewish family. And so because he does that, he causes the death of himself, the Jewish family, and his own family. They all get killed. And this story is an echo of the story from issue 1 about the young boy in the school drawing a picture of God. And the teacher says, well, we have no image of God. And the young boy says, well, now we do. So these stories, these metaphorical stories that are called back upon, call into question ideas of mortality and of divinity, and all that is part of the story of Mr. Miracle. And this is going to be a little bit NSFW, so I'm telling you right now, come back in 20 seconds if you don't want to see an SFW image, but it's going to be the head of Granny Goodness. It's a little bit NSFW, not completely. And the reason that this is important, the reason why I'm showing you this, is because there's a fight at the very end between Orion and Mr. Miracle, where Mr. Miracle's already been warned before by Metreon not to stare into the face of God. And during the fight, Orion tells him, look at my face, and stare at the face of God. And as he does that, we get those disruption patterns, the video squiggles, that tell us that Darkseid's influencing reality in some way. And as Orion beats Mr. Miracle, and Mr. Miracle stares at Orion's face, we get a glimpse of Darkseid's face underneath Orion's face. It's all part of the idea of the corrupting influence of Darkseid, that there's a little bit of dark side in any of us. This comes from when Tom King, so here's my story for you kiddos, story about the creator Tom King. When Tom King was first assigned to write Mr. Miracle, he said, well, I don't know if I have a good take on dark side. To me, he's just another Thanos. And the friend that he was talking to said, no, you've got it all wrong. If you recall, Thanos is the villain in the current Avengers film who gains control of the Infinity Gauntlet. And so he's able to manifest his will upon reality, time, space. Oh, I can't remember. I had meant to memorize all the all the five rings of the Infinity Gauntlet. I failed. I have a couple of them. But he's able to manifest his will upon all creation, more or less. But his friend said, no, Darkseid is that really bad day you have when everything you know goes wrong for you. Darkseid is that day when your girlfriend cheats on you. And so the big difference is Thanos imposes his will from outside in, but Darkseid imposes his will from out from inside out. Let me turn off the sound so we can't hear that beep what we just heard. Here we go. All right. Off. Sound gone. Beep gone. And I bring all that up because we see that influence here that Orion, we're given the clue that Orion's now been corrupted. And Mr. Miracle alludes to when he committed suicide, he feels that day he was under the influence of Darkseid. And it's very much that Judeo-Christian belief of God gives us salvation because in all of us there is sin. Satan is in all of us, and all of us, despite our best intentions, can do evil. And the only way we can overcome that is through salvation, through God. And as I had alluded to before, that the new God mythology is Judeo-Christian at its root. And one evidence of this is that the name for High Father, who is the father of Scot-Free, is, I believe, Isaiah. I wrote it down. I don't know if we cover it this episode, but next episode, I think, we'll go over the history of High Father. I can check it right now. So I'll be back in 3, 2, 1. And yes, Isaiah is the name of the High Father's real name, and that is based on Isaiah. Somewhat lost my train of thought during that break, so let me just talk about the format of the story. It's a postmodern superhero comic book, and it got a lot of attention when it first came out because of how unusual it is. It doesn't feel like anything on the stands, and in my opinion, it doesn't feel like anything ever. It's very unique. And so at first, that really caught me, like, what is it about this that makes it different? One thing is the humor and the way that it's mixed with the high drama. And then you mix in the superheroics. And it occurred to me while thinking about this issue for recording this review, what is the closest analog? And what I found, I think the closest analog is the Greek dramas or Shakespearean dramas that are about the kings and their court and the drama that revolves around that court. So we would call that what high historical drama mixed in with superheroics. And go with me on this. There is a palace. That's where High Father lives. And then when Orion assumes the mantle of High Father, that's where he goes. We have the palace intrigue. There's a lot of the politicking. There's the battle, just like in Henry V or any of the historical plays that Shakespeare did. And the part that seems a little confusing, that seems odd, is all the action that takes place in Scot-Free's apartment. And that's what feels like the odd man out. But if you think you think of Scot-Free's apartment as just being an anteroom within the palace, then it doesn't seem so weird anymore. Scot-Free goes to the court, does his business, and goes back to his anteroom where he gets to converse with his wife and other courtiers. They plot, and then we go back to the courtroom again, where the plot gets furthered. But here, the one thing that makes that possible is the boom tube, because the action can take place anywhere, any planet, any room. So instead of being in an anteroom within the palace, it's just on Earth in Scott Free's apartment. And once that analogy occurred to me, it all began to be clear, not so odd. Scenes that just felt kind of weird and strange made more sense. It's still kind of a little bit of a satire, and it's definitely not the high drama that we're used to or the superhero comic book, thank God. That's what made it so different, makes it so different. But there are analogies that make sense. Next, let's go over biographies for two characters. I want to do at least two each, but there are so many characters in the New God universe. I may have to up it to three, but I think it's going to be helpful for the people who are not so familiar with DC characters and come to this series because of the great criticism that it's gotten, the great reviews. And I'm cognizant of the fact that the graphic novel, the collection of the individual issues, is being released as I record in about 4 days, 3 days, this coming week. And there may be some people who come to this review because of getting the graphic novel who are just not familiar with the character. So I'm going to do this because I think it'll be worthwhile for those people, get them up to speed. Let's go over Scott Free, Mr. Miracle, the Taylor. This is the second time I'm recording this. The first one was ruined because of sound problems, and I had problems saying titular, and I had problems the first time. The titular character, Scott Free. Scott Free is the world's greatest escape artist, and he's a new god. His father is High Father, ruler of New Genesis. He was traded to Darkseid as a child for Darkseid's son Orion to preserve the peace between New Genesis and Apocalypse. And that's where we get back into the parody of high historical drama. This is something they did in history. And you see it also in Game of Thrones, since Game of Thrones is modeled on the War of the Roses, where some of those members have been traded to opposite families to prevent a war from breaking out. He was raised in one of Granny Goodness's orphanages, and there he fell in love with Big Barda, of the female Furies. Together they escaped to Apocalypse and moved to Earth, where they began to fight crime and eventually became members of the Justice League. The next character I want to discuss is Forager. Forager is one of the bugs of New Genesis. They're usually treated as a subspecies, but Forager's bravery in battle led to him being respected by the New Gods. The species that Forager is a member of evolved from microlife that spread on New Genesis during the war, an earlier war between New Genesis and Apocalypse. And this society are a society of humanoid-like bugs, that thrive in the colonies beneath the surface of the planet. Now let's discuss the art by Mitch Gerads. And something that he's been doing in this series is that he will use one primary color for each sequence and put it as the backdrop, and then he'll either use contrasting colors or complementary shades. So, for example, the NSFW, well, I'll just switch it so that we don't have to worry about that, but the opening panels where he's using red for the backdrop, and then complementary shades of red or purple, and then blues for contrast. And then one way that he uses this very significantly is in the final, well, the final battle of the issue between Orion and Scott Free. Both of them have similar colors on their costumes. They have both have red and green. And Orion has, what does he have? He has red and yellow. Scott Free has red, yellow, and green. So they both share the color red and yellow. And to make Scott Free stand out, we focus on the cape, which is kind of an offset color to yellow. Let me get in really close. So Scott Free is the one we see his back. The cape, that green differentiates him from the yellow. And then Orion really stands out because of that red. Let's see, I'm manually getting focus on there. So between the two of them, that red and the green, they stand out from the yellow, even though they all have similar colors, the way that the conflict is staged by putting Scott Free's back to us and giving us Orion's front side, the red and the green stand out from the yellow and from each other. Very brilliantly staged. That's a master class in using color. And then the last page that I alluded to, we get, he adds in that blue for Darkseid's influence. Darkseid's face is blue. That may have been the reason why he went for the yellow background, knowing that the very last panels, wait, hold on, this is very difficult to do. The very last panels, he would be flashing into Darkseid's face, and Darkseid being blue, he may have begun the challenge there. So if Darkseid's blue, blue's going to intrude upon the scene, then what color can I use in the pages leading up to that that will contrast with the blue? So he thought maybe yellow. Okay, I have yellow or orange. And then what can I do in this fight that will make Orion and Scott Free stand out since they have similar colors to that? So that big puzzle, I think, was all precipitated by the final panel of Darkseid breaking through Orion. And that's about all I have for now. I don't have any trivia. I don't have, in case you missed it. Oh, wait, I do want to, there is one last thing I want to go over, one last scene. And that's when, again, the domesticity of the series is also another thing that sets it out. So you get the high drama and the superheroics, and as contrast, we get the relationship between Big Barda and Scott, which is good. Developing that relationship gives us, the reader, something to latch on to, because really, truthfully, the idea of the corrupting influence of Darkseid, intellectually, that is intriguing, but we need heart, and heart comes from Big Barda and Scott. But there's a little comment here about, as there is throughout all the series, about media, and as Big Barda and Scott Free are discussing their problems with the war, they get interrupted by a fan who sees them and wants to take a selfie with them. So it's cute, it's relevant, it makes it contemporary, but it also juxtaposes the fact that their drama is also still set into relief for the fact that they are celebrities, and being a celebrity has a drama, a story of its own. No matter how important or super serious this battle is on New Genesis, they also are on Earth, and they have a secondary story, a secondary narrative, and that's of being celebrities. And it's cute. He uses comedic timing really well, the way she interrupts to introduce a little levity into the scene. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, trying to get focus on me. That's it. That's all I have. So we're done for today. All right. Well, if you are just joining this now because you picked up the graphic novel this week, welcome. I hope you'll continue with the rest of the series. I plan to release about one episode a week. So if you're reading it and you read ahead, please come back. And for those who have read before, I hope you will continue. Any feedback you can give me, I'll much appreciate. So comment if you watch this. That's all for now. Take care. Be well. Dark Side is.